Hello everyone, myself dietitian Diksha Dayal. I'm a nutrition consultant at Diet Play at Gujarawala Town. As we all know, Navratris are hidden. So today we will talk about diet in Navratri. Navratris in India are important sacred festival, and we all in India celebrate all the festivals, festivities with food. So today we will talk about what to eat and what not to eat during the Navratri diet. Most of all, what we do, Navratri is a detoxification period for our body. But instead of detoxification, we all feed our body with more of the fats and carbohydrates. So here are few tips that you can take care of to, you know, have a detoxified Navratris for yourself. So majorly, get moving. Eat more of vegetables, stay yourself hydrated, and eat low of junk food, that is fried food, as we all munch on chips and potatoes. So these are the carbohydrates that will not help you to detox your body as well as not even to reduce the weight. Now we will talk about the common foods that we eat during Navratris. First is sabudana. So sabudana, although it's a starchy in nature, but still it's come with many nutritional benefits. So sabudana helps us in improving the heart function. It helps us in enhancing the exercise performance also. Plus it is a very rich source of antioxidant. Another will be rajgiri, that is amaranth. So amaranth is very good source of phosphorus. It is rich in protein and fiber, which helps in digestion also. Plus the main function of the amaranth is it is very rich in manganese, which helps us in brain function. Another that we will talk about is samak. So samak is very good replacement for all the rice eaters. It is very rich in fiber, very good for digestion, and powerfully packed with all the antioxidants and vitamins and minerals. So next is buckwheat, that is kutuka atta. So now kutuka atta is very good for fiber. They are very good for your digestion. It helps in relieving the constipation also. They are packed with many vitamins like riboflavin, thiamine, ricin, vitamin K, and your vitamin B6, which is a rare combination of all the vitamins in one source. Kutuka atta also helps us in curing and protecting our diabetes, insulin resistant level, that is managing our diabetes, but it is very good for weight loss also. Now last but not the least in my list is chestnut, that is singhade ka atta. So singhade ka atta is very much rich in copper and vitamin C. It is full of antioxidants. It is really good for those who are looking to get rid of acidity and heartburn. So I hope this video will really help you to have a good Navratris and a detoxified Navratris. Happy fasting. In case you want to contact me, you can always contact me through Lybrate.com. Thank you.